What's going on, guys? Machiam Fan 2010 here, and today we're back here with episode 3 of Monster Jam Fan 2010's commentary series. Now today is going to be a bit of a darker type of video. It's been like kind of a topic I've been wanting to get to because it's something that not many people know about, and it's just something that I've always wondered kind of and seen around. So it's just probably something I kind of want to do as a video. And this is one of the videos I've been thinking about for a long time and doing. However, because there is going to be a certain amount of people that will find it this way a bit disturbing, like, even though I'm probably going to try not to talk about much of the actual disturbing portions of this, just to be on the safe side, viewer discretion is advised just at certain portions of the video, just for, like, safe reasons. Anyways, with that being said, it's time to get into the main topic portion. The worst two-week period in Monster Jam history. Everyone knows the risks of running a monster truck. The drivers know the risks. They do this. Even though injuries are not commonplace, they can happen. However, something that most do not think of is the fans. The fans' safety is something that most people don't think of. However, Monster Jam already has a major extreme of this, where if a truck gets out of control, not only do they have the RII system, but they also have the first 5 to 10 rows barred it off so that people don't stand there in case a truck gets out of control. There's a few examples of this. Then one will actually be shown why this is in first of all in place. And this has been something that's been just said more since like the 90s. And that in itself could probably be its own video in the future. That being said, it's time to get into the main portion, as we have two separate incidents that would end up affecting monster trucks. And not only that, but just overall, the entire aspect of this year would be bad. We're talking about 2009 here. So first off, what makes 2009 so bad? Oh yeah, the 2008 financial crisis was near its peak at this time. So already we're off to a great start. But what truly was going on in monster trucks? Well, for Gravedigger, they were having their best season yet. Dennis Anderson and Papa Huffaker are having their best seasons of their careers. Chad Tingler's doing very well in freestyles. And to say the least, for Charlie Pocket, no one really knows what's going on because we've not seen a stadium appearance from the truck of the newly acquired Gravedigger 22 yet. However, of the others are doing a little underwhelming. Overall, Gary Porter, he's doing a good driving. It's just Gravedigger 12 at this point, at least with what it features, is a little bit outdated. It needs a little bit more of upgrading. And Rod Schmidt, no one cares. And Randy Brown is doing Randy Brown things and is screwing away about everything, including event victories. So at this point, we're already off to a good start. However, Maximum Destruction is having probably their worst season yet. The hiring of Craig Christensen is not looking good, and Tom Mintz is having not good luck at all. In fact, it's actually terrible luck. Now, look forward, it's about to get a lot worse with Max Deeds, but basically what this has caused with Max Deeds' incompetence has been a whole new slew of drivers like Escalade, Air Force Afterburner Taz, Bounty Hunter especially, and the Blue Thunder team have all been able to upgrade where they've been running well, kind of like, you know, closer to the middle pack to now up front to challenge Gravedigger, as that's very basically their only adversary, especially with Escalade. However, that's not the main portion of the season. The main thing is to talk about other incidents. Now, as for what was happening around that weekend, I about listed everything off. Well, sort of. Dennis Anderson ended up doing some type of, like, giant wheelie kind of stand. Gary Porter in the Gravedigger 12 was in Houston somehow for the thrill show, but that's not the main focus. Safe Out Minimizer's incredible save happened there in Houston, which somehow you can say was a save. Tomitz absolutely threw down in San Diego and destroyed his entire truck at the process. Then we have Minneapolis. Chad Tingler is able to throw down a great freestyle as Bounty Hunter actually won racing incredibly. Oh boy. And there's this one show that I'm forgetting, but probably for good reason. Anyways, the main portion though, Rod Schmidt was out there for an event in Tacoma. And this is where our first part takes place, Tacoma, Washington. Tacoma has been a place where we've seen some type of strange moments, as we saw in 2002, and the mistake in 2008, that it has to be a mistake, of Gravedigger's theme song accidentally being Hell's Bells by AC/DC instead of Bad to the Bone, that type of stuff. So the Tacoma Dome has not been left out of strange moments. However, this one though does not go as well. As early on in the freestyle running order, Natural High, a truck that had been around since the mid-2000s, as this is the end of the 2000s, was finishing up its freestyle. However, at the end, some part of the under portion of the truck, I think some like the axles, would end up breaking off and hurtled into the grandstands. Here's the video. Now, I'm not going to try and imagine what that sound could be, and I'm not going to talk about any more of that, but ultimately, it would tragically end up hitting and killing a six-year-old boy. And the family were absolutely devastated and tried to sue Feld. But of course, like we would think, Feld would win. Now, what this would do is end up making safety changes. I believe they'd have it where the axles would like be able to cover by something so that this doesn't happen again. And because of this, this created another type of controversy that you'll see a little bit later on, later on in the video. Now, we head to the next wave. Feld has already had a lot of controversy going around about us. How about another company? And it's been more of kind of an independent monster truck league. Toward the end of racing, actually it was more of the final round of racing, Holman's Beast and Samson are racing on a Thunder Nationals type of looking course. And at the end of the race, the finals is over, you know, they're both heading back to the garage, Samson is, and the promoter, who I'm gonna flash the name of, just randomly out of nowhere stepped out in front. And I'm not gonna say how this ended, but it is bad. And it was too late for Dan Patrick and Samson to see him. So basically a horror side was found, and unfortunately it was witnessed by a lot of people. Now, something else that needs to be published is that if there were charges that were on Dan Patrick, it was dropped, like, if there were, but obviously Dan Patrick is a veteran, 20 plus years, he couldn't see, and there was no reason really for him, the promoter, to step out, so it was like a freak incident. However, this just added to some type of strange curse into the year of 2009, and it's not like either Moshin was away from this. Well, maybe not, like, at the point of tragedy. We saw another weird type of kind of tragedy, not exactly of how people, but more of just an entire show. The horrifying Indianapolis 2009 show, specifically the freestyle show, for how horrifically bad it was. Legitimately, I talked more about this in episode one of the worst shows of all time, but ultimately, it was bad, that's all I'll say. So, what did this really do? This put a lot of eyes on monster trucking. That was this really safe at all? We all know it's not safe. However, for basically everything, it was just a lot of very unfortunate sequences of events. Now, throughout the 2009 season, if you guys wonder how the 2009 season ended up, Gravedigger would still dominate. Maximum Destruction would not continue to get good. In fact, they almost got worse until World Finals. And overall, many of the other midfields tried, but they could not stop Gravedigger. Well, besides Bounty Hunter and Taz. Now, with that being said, what exactly happened at the World Finals, and what was it that the Natural High incident caused? Well, big one at the World Finals, there were three incidents there that got censored on the American Speed and DVD version of World Finals 10. And though that was a infamous Captain's Curse crash, Nitro Circus's crash at the end of its freestyle, and Gravedigger's crash in the middle of its freestyle were all censored on everything that was American TV, Speed, and the DVDs. However, in Europe, they were all shown, as you're seeing on the screen right now. Ultimately, it just maybe to have, like, not any more, like, media around it, they said would censor, but ultimately create another type of media storm. However, that it's not been seen until very recent, and really known that it exists. But obviously, eventually, there's also a possibility that the natural high incident may have caused course design to go downhill, with how they started taking out less and less crash cars. They probably need to, like, more have a little more dirt around it, kind of like the 2010s to 2012 designs, just because of, like, you know, we saw pretty bad freestyle shows at certain tracks, and overall, it was probably somewhere they took it down. However, it got worse and worse after, like, 2013, until where it's at today. And that's just overall kind of just how everything went. Now, if anybody's wondering how everyone ended up out of this, well, don't worry. At least for the drivers. Yeah, specifically Randy Brown continued to do his usual things. Well, anyways, guys, that was episode 3 of Moshing Fan 2010's commentary series. Hope you guys enjoyed. Like it helps the channel. Subscribe for more content, as I don't only do these commentary series videos, I also do gaming videos, and I'm doing a lot more European videos. And I have some pretty big projects coming out real soon. And hit the bell for notifications so you can see these videos early, because YouTube doesn't like me. Anyways, that being said, I'll see you guys next time.